Born in Kentucky, just 100 miles apart, Abraham Lincoln and Jefferson Davis led Americans in the struggle for the soul of the nation in the American Civil War. Davis as president of the pro-slavery Confederate States, and Lincoln as president of the United States. Understanding how their backgrounds and beliefs differed helps us understand Kentucky's complicated divide on the issue of slavery itself. Both men were born into agricultural families and left Kentucky at a young age. Lincoln received almost no formal education and had to work extra hard to establish a career in politics. Davis, meanwhile, attended the prestigious Transylvania University, known for producing accomplished leaders. In 1861, both men were elected president. As leader of the Confederacy, Davis fought to maintain the institution of slavery. He backed Kentucky Senator John Crittenden's unsuccessful attempt to permanently enshrine slavery into the U.S. Constitution. Although Lincoln considered black people to be inferior to white people, he didn't believe that slavery was financially viable, and his number one goal was to keep the Union together. The loyalties of Kentucky citizens were similarly divided. The state stayed neutral until troops occupied Columbus. Many Kentuckians celebrated when the war ended in Confederate surrender. Yet the 13th Amendment, which abolished the institution of slavery in 1865, was not ratified in Kentucky until 1976. So, what became of the Civil War's two foremost leaders? Just a few days after the Union secured victory, Lincoln was assassinated by Confederate spy John Wilkes Booth. Davis, meanwhile, was charged with treason and thrown in jail. What if the president had come from a northern state and the Confederate leader from a southern state?